Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel The Beauty Company. Hope you all are doing safe and healthy. Today I've created this gorgeous makeup look for this year's holiday season and hope you guys will enjoy and find this video helpful. Also, for your reference, I have mentioned every product details in the description box, so please don't forget to check it out. Now without any further delay, let's jump into this video. So first of all, we are going to start with moisturizing our face, which I have already done off camera. Next, I am using my Mars Hydro Glow Primer. This will provide me a very good hydration during this winters and also it will give me a radiant look. Next, I am using my favorite brow pencil from Miss Claire in the shade Dark Brown. So I will be carving out my brows and then filling it in with the same brow pencil. Also, I will be drawing some fake hairs towards the inner parts of my brows. Next, I am going to set the brow hairs with my favorite essence brow gel in the shade Brownie Brows. Then I'm going to use my all-time favorite Milani Conceal Plus Perfect Foundation and this I will be dotting it in onto my face with a beauty blender and then pressing the product into my skin and blending it very nicely. Next, I'm going to use my favorite concealer again. In this video, you will see a lot of favorite products that I love using. So I will be highlighting the center of my face and towards the inner and outer corner of my eyes and also around my mouth area and blending it out with my beauty blender. Then comes contouring part. So today I will be doing some cream contour. So I will be contouring the hollows of my cheeks, the forehead, my jawline and also the sides of my nose to make my nose look little slimmer. As you all can see that my nose is pretty broad, so I want to make it slim and blending it out with my beauty blender again. During winters, our skin tends to become dry, so it is always better to use as many cream products as possible. And you can use less powder product if you have dry skin like me. So I basically like to use more of cream and little bit of powder. With the same Flower Beauty concealer, I'm going to highlight below the cheekbone area to give me a nice chiseled look. Now I'm setting all the highlighted areas in place with my another favorite Rimmel translucent loose powder, and this is a very nice finely milled powder which is very lightweight, doesn't give any flashback or cakiness. For our eye look today, I'm going to use ColourPop Dream State palette in collaboration with Kathleen Lights, taking this shade, and this will be my first transition. Next, I'm going to build up my transition and make it more intense with this shade and starting from my outer and then bringing it in towards my inner corners of the eyes. Taking this nice forest green shade and placing it on the outer V. And slowly I will blend just the outer edges. Then I will be taking this nice duochrome shade which has a hint of green and silver in it and I will be placing it on my lid space. With this forest green shimmery eyeshadow, I will be placing it where the two colors meet and I will also blend the edges of the same. I have created a nice little winged eyeliner using my Lakme Iconic eyeliner in black, and then for my lower waterline I have used this eye pencil from Nykaa. This has a very nice teal sea green shade and then I'm smudging it out with a pencil brush. Using this champagne gold shade to highlight the inner tear duct area as well as the brow bone area. To bronze up my skin and set the cream contour in place, I have used Wet n Wild bronzing our contouring palette and this I will be using in the areas like the jawline, little bit on the forehead and on the hollows of my cheeks, and using the same to contour my nose as well. Using my Sigma blush in the shade Serene, I will be blushing the apples of my cheeks and tip of the nose. This has a very nice mauvey, dusty pink shade and it looks good on every skin tone. To bring back that glow to my face, I will be using a highlighter to highlight the highest points of my face like the cheekbone area, the bridge of the nose, tip of the nose, cupid's bow, chin, and then I will be setting it out with a dewy setting spray. Next, I'm curling my eyelashes for the next step. So over here I have already applied my fake lashes and now tight lining my upper waterline area and using a mascara to merge my natural lashes with the fake ones. Rubbing off the lip balm from my lips now that my lips feels much more hydrated than before. Lining my lips prior to the lipstick, and after that I will be using my Faces Canada lip crayon in the shade Natural Cocoa, and this is a very nice nude shade that suits every Indian skin tone. And here is the completed makeup look.